Hey everyone, my name's Neil. I work here at Sports Attack, and I'm going to be walking you through some key component replacements on some of our machines. This video is going to walk you through replacing the bottom motor for an Attack and an Attack 2 volleyball machine. So we're going to show you how to put the head on the machine. Under the frame, make sure you lock your casters. Grab this. Make sure it locks. Make sure this is unscrewed so your head will slide down. So you can lock it into place. So that's that. So now when you want to remove the head, just unscrew this. That's it. Okay, so we're going to be replacing the bottom motor on a volleyball Attack or an Attack 2. Make sure your machine's turned off and unplugged from power. I'm going to rotate it, kind of try to show you guys a better picture. And so we're going to start with taking the wheel cover off. You're going to need 7/16 wrench, 7/16 socket, half inch socket, wire clip cutters, Phillips number 2 screwdriver. Okay, so on this bottom bolt here, well, depending on how you're looking at it, this one has a rubber washer in between the wheel and the frame, so make sure you do not lose that. So when you pull this bolt out, the rubber washer is going to fall. Because it seats in between this frame, and we'll show you close-up pictures of it. Okay, so now half inch wrench and you can remove the wheel. Don't lose your hardware. It has a lock washer and a big washer for your wheel. And your key for that. Don't lose that. So now you can remove these two bolts to take this half of the wheel cover off. So now that you got the wheel covers removed, you can clip all the zip ties, free up your wire. Okay, so we're gonna remove the controller now and disconnect the motor. Okay, so make sure you don't lose these lock washers on these little screws. So all you need to do is disconnect motor 3, and it's labeled MOT3 on both these. Do not pull by the wire. Grab the terminal and wiggle it. And free that up. Okay, so you don't need to pull this nut all the way off, but you need to back it. You do need to back it off a little ways so that you can free up that wire clamp, which we'll show you. Now you can just loosen this up. So now you're ready to pull your motor out. Okay, so now we can take the motor bolts out. Now you're ready, you can slide the motor out. And you're ready to replace it. Okay, so now just mount your new motor. Snug down all your bolts. Okay, so now you can wrap your motor cable and you'll zip tie it in a few spots here. So the first one's going to be on this side of this bracket. We turn these in just cosmetically so you don't see it on the face of the machine, which is the operator's view, kind of hide them from that. So now you'll just continue to zip tie these two wires together, starting up here. And you want to put one about every 3 or 4 inches or so. So that's what it's going to end up looking like. And I'm going to clip all these ends off now. Okay, so you can run this back through the box now. There's going to be a certain amount of slack you need in this cable, and we'll show you that. Okay, so now that we have those wires all zip tied, we're going to unplug the other motor now. because this part, you need to have a certain amount of slack in here. So obviously you're gonna need enough for the machine to go up all the way. But you wanna have enough to where it can go down. Okay, so when you determine the amount of slack you need, which you can see how the loop I have here, and I can kind of show you before I clamp them, the movement on the machine. So that's maxed out. And then it's going to come in. And it looked like that. You're only going to shoot the machine so low, so. So now, once you're comfortable with that, you can clamp them back together. So now you can connect the controller back up and mount it. Now you'll just follow your wires, even though you've only replaced the one motor, and the middle hole in the box is where your bottom motor is, which is going to connect to motor 3. But you should always still make sure and follow your wires and nothing got switched up on you when you pulled it out. So you can connect motor 3 back up. And connect motor 1. Push the wires to the side and free up space where all your connectors are. Okay, so you're ready to move on to the wheel covers now on the wheel. So now I've just replaced the bottom wheel covering. Ready to put the wheel on. So again, the holes where the wheel is balanced will face inside. Then you just line the slots up and put the key in. Hold back on. Now you can put the other half of the wheel cover on. Okay, so this bolt is the one that goes into the frame that has the rubber washer that will sit in between the frame and the wheel cover. Just keep in mind that this bolt is a little bit longer than the remaining bolts on that wheel cover. So if you're having a problem getting that this bolt in, you might have switched them up. So there are different lengths. This is the only one though that is a different length. Okay, so the rubber washer is going to seat in between the wheel covers and the frame itself. So you can put your bolt through the covers, both covers, and then slide that washer, rubber washer, onto it now. now you can tighten them all up. Okay, so the covers are for the most part lined up, but you can kind of get them perfect. You just line them up and get it snug. Tighten all remaining bolts. Okay, you should be ready to test the machine now. Making sure you have all the slack you need. Okay, so now you're ready to test it. Make sure it's off and turn down to zero, both knobs, before plugging it in. So you're going to test a visual inspection that the rotation is going the correct way. And then you can turn each motor on individually so that you know that you're on the right channels. That's it.